conquering the queue with the bicep there. All right, so people very anxious, obviously, about money. To help us talk through the challenging times in that context, personal finance expert Farnoosh Torabi is with us. Farnoosh, good to have you on. So many things to cover here. Why don't we start with, if there's not money coming in, what do you do?
Well, obviously, well, first, thanks for having me. This is such a difficult subject. There are no words to describe how hard it is for people right now. But I think to answer your question, Ryan, if you don't have money coming in, you need to understand that help is out there. The most important thing everybody has to do right now is to not hide behind the emotional trauma that is losing your job. I know there's so much that we feel, whether that's embarrassment, we feel shame, we don't talk about money as a culture. Now is not the time to not talk. Now is the time to ask for help, pick up your phone. You can call your lenders, you can call your billers, explain that you've been impacted by COVID-19 financially, whether that's you've lost your job, you've been furloughed, or you've had to take care of a loved one and can't work, or you have high medical bills. These are the reasons people are getting help. It's not gonna knock on your door. Money's not going to arrive at your doorstep, but there is help out there. You just have to ask for it.
What if you can't pay your mortgage right now or your rent right now? What is your protection?
So thanks to the stimulus, the $2.2 trillion stimulus, now lenders are providing mortgage forbearance to some mortgage borrowers. If you have a federally backed mortgage, you just call up your lender, explain that you're experiencing hardship, and you can, for up to a period of 180 days, 6 months, get your mortgage principal and interest basically put aside for the time being. It doesn't impact your credit, but it's the sort of thing that, again, your mortgage company's not going to call you and say, hey, we've got this opportunity. You need to call and explain and get enrolled.
And what about for renters? What's the best plan for renters?
So for renters, there isn't this sort of official thing like with the mortgage forbearance, right. But I'm hearing from a lot of people success by, again, picking up the phone, calling your landlord and explain that you've been impacted by COVID-19, that you've lost your job, et cetera. And the key here is to present some solutions, say, you know, I can do half of what I did last month, or can we maybe pick up things in June or July until I get back on my feet? And a lot of landlords are making these sorts of arrangements. But again, it's the sort of thing where you really need to negotiate. I want everyone to know that if you are renting right now and you're coming up to the end of your lease, you have some leverage here, because I'm seeing a lot of offers, landlords trying to get people to move in with free months or discounted rent. And so you can explain, like, you want to stay, can I get a discount on the new lease? Can I get a couple of months free? You might actually have some leverage.
I keep hearing from a lot of people that are saying that when they call for help, when they call their banks, when they call their mortgage companies, they're unable to get through. What do you advise to people who cannot get through?
Don't give up. You're absolutely right. I was reading today in the Wall Street Journal about just, you know, the backlog. There is right now a lot of people calling, and you may get somebody who isn't up to date on the laws. You just have to keep calling. That's the unfortunate reality right now that we're in. But I would also say that you can go into the chat rooms sometimes online. In addition to a hotline, there's also a free chat tool where you can potentially get to speak with someone that way. It could be faster. And for people who are a little nervous getting on the phone, it's a great way to communicate via email or chat. But I would also say there are organizations out there, not-for-profits, like the National Foundation for Credit Counseling, nfcc.org. Mm-hmm. They're set up to be your advocate. So they sometimes it helps to get that middle person, and it's a free resource for everybody.
Got it. Well, some great tips here. We'll put up on our website and Farnoosh's podcast called So Money with Farnoosh.
Yeah.
Torabi, thanks so much for coming on.
Thanks you so Farnoosh. Much.